Hi, welcome to No Aim, No Gain. In this video, I'm going to be discussing about Robert Kiyosaki. Now, whenever you're working in a 9-to-5 job, you're always going to be bogged down with more work and even more stress. And that doesn't leave you much time to have financial freedom. I myself have experienced this situation, and gradually over time, I have managed to get myself out of this the rat race and actually setting up my own business, which has its loads of benefits. Although it may have a lot of setbacks, it does have its more benefits than working in a 9-to-5 job. Well, where did my inspiration came from? Well, I first started to read contents from Robert Kiyosaki myself, and that's actually the starting point of taking me into the direction of working into the cash flow quadrant, where he's actually mentioned the business owner. So I've moved from the left side of the cash flow, the quadrant, to the right hand side, and that's what I'm going to be discussing. Now, I would definitely recommend you stick to the end, because it's going to get very interesting about what you can learn from Robert Kiyosaki's non-tips that I have gathered and refined to make it more simple for you to understand today, which you can take away. Now, I guarantee you one of these steps you have come across and you have been able to tackle it. So what I'm going to do for you today is I'm going to go through step by step Robert Kiyosaki's main tips that I've picked up on, which I believe that you'd get value from today. So be sure to subscribe the channel, hit the bell notification for more videos. So let's get into it today. Number one, there are four parts to the quadrant. So you've got the employed, the self-employed, the business owner, and the investor. Now, what you want to try to do is get yourself from the left-hand side, the employee, and the self-employed, to the right-hand side. Now, obviously, it requires a lot of capital and a lot of risk-taking in business. But, I mean, if you take the slow and gradual steps, you'll eventually get there. Now, if you haven't already checked my previous videos, I've discussed 9 ways that you can make money online. So potentially what you can do as a starting point is use one of those areas that you can make money online, potentially get yourself out of the rat race of the 9-to-5 and just gradually move onto the right hand side of the cash flow quadrant. So what's Mr. Kiyosaki going on about when he's mentioned the four quadrants? Well, basically, people on the left hand side, they're working for earned income, whereas people on the right hand side, the business owners and the investors, are having money working for them. So if you wanted to learn more, I recommend reading the Rich Dad Poor Dad book. They've also got quite a few other contents, and I'll also be having Mr. Robert Kiyosaki myself and an interview at a later stage. So again, I recommend you subscribe and subscribe to our channel. Number two, assets, not liabilities. So what you need to be looking at is building asset base rather than liabilities. So when you're making money, what you need to be doing is concentrating on putting money that's going to work for you rather than you working for money. A lot of people these days, when they make a lot of money, what tend to happen is the expenses also go up. So if, for instance, if they get promotion, eventually something might happen, like they might increase their expenses, purchase a new car, go on more holidays over the year. So what you don't want to be doing is getting entangled into that. What would be better would be gradually possibly creating value by getting an asset. So what is an example of an asset? Something such as a real estate. So you purchase properties, but I mean, like I mentioned in my previous videos, it's not as simple just to purchase properties, because it can take a long time. So a simplified version of that is possibly using your vehicle as a asset. How can you do that? So you can possibly rent out your vehicle, and now it's turned into an asset because it has been generating you money. That's a more simplified way rather than the complexity of purchasing properties. Number three, make money work for you rather than working for the money. So So if you're working in a 9-to-5, what you're going to be doing is actually going to be working for the money, whereas investors and business owners, they have rental income coming in for them, so they're basically making money while they're sleeping. That's really important aspect that you need to look at, because if you are working for money, then if something tragic happens or something happens, then stops you from working in a job, doing your 9-to-5 job, then it's going to have dire consequences, especially if you've got a mortgage that you need paying. So having rental income pay for the mortgage or something similar is going to actually work as a cushion for you. So that's where I'd recommend looking at ways to have money working for you. Again, I'd definitely recommend you go check out my video, 9 steps, ways to make money online, because there are ways that you can actually make money passively. For instance, if you got spare space in your house where you with spare rooms in your house that you can possibly rent out, that can actually pay towards towards your rent or your mortgage, or you've got a spare driveway. Again, that's passive income, because you're actually not working for the money. That's just something that you can, a space that you can utilize without you having to actually physically do anything. Number 5, practice, fail until you eventually succeed. So whatever we do in life, you're always going to fail. We're not going to get it right. So you need to be looking at ways that you can possibly look on your setback and how you can better yourself in succeeding. Number 6, the budgeting system. I think this one was the most important one for me that I've worked on in my business career, because it actually affects your personal life and your business life. Like I mentioned earlier, say for instance your salary goes up, what automatically people do in those situations is the expenses also go up. So you need to really be having some sort of budgeting system where you keep your manage your expenses and look at being cash flow positive, because if you're cash flow positive at the end of the month, then you're actually developing and you're actually getting better. That's the same mentality in business as well. Now with startups, they do require a lot of money down, so again they do budget themselves, but really what you want to be doing at the end of every month, you want to be minimizing your expenses as best as you can, and then trying to looking at ways how you can increase your income. And I think those are the best win, those are the people that are actually winning, where they're actually looking at how we can minimize our costs as a business, and as an individual personally, ways that you can save your costs and your cash flow positive. That's the reason why a lot of people get into debt, is because a lot of their expenses are more than actually incoming, and that's where they get into a lot of debt with the credit cards, and it can have dire consequences. Number 7, never stop learning. So one point that I picked up from Robert Kiyosaki is that you always need to be constantly learning about your financial life and ways that you can improve yourself. I mean, I always am always reading and always trying to learn and better my financial situation. I believe that you need to really looking at your finances and ways that you can manage your cash flow and budgeting, which is really important, especially if you are going to go into business. Because if you can't handle your personal expenses, then unfortunately the business element is going to be very difficult. Now it's all good making loads of money, but if you're not keeping a track of all your expenses and they're going out of control, then really you're actually making a loss at the end of the day, because you have to factor in all your unexpected expenses. You've got look at all your taxes that you have to pay when it comes to business, managing a business. So those are really important. So the best way is through learning from from experience. Failing, it's okay to fail. It happens in life, it happens to the best of us. If we didn't fail, then we wouldn't learn. So mistakes do happen, so just bear that in mind. Don't feel stupid because you made a mistake. A lot of people, there's two types of people that make mistakes: those that learn from it and move on, and those that kick themselves and just give up. So you don't want to be the person that gives up. You just want to keep moving, keep going forward, and hopefully you should succeed. So those are the 7 points that I've picked up from Mr. Robert Kiyosaki. Like I mentioned, I will be getting Mr. Kiyosaki at a later stage. So, I mean, that's going to be very interesting. So I'd appreciate if you subscribe to our channel, because I will be going into an in-depth conversation with Mr. Kiyosaki, and it will add value to your life, wherever you are, whoever you are, regardless of what income, what job you are in, regardless of what job you're in, it's going to affect you. Be sure to also like the channel, subscribe, and hit the bell notification, because we will be putting out at least about two to three videos per week, and even more at a later stage. So we'll be adding a lot more value to your life, and I want to really try to create content where it's actually going to motivate you, so you actually benefit from our content. Thank you for watching. Have a nice day.